First of all, I would like to thank our ACP India chapter governor, Dr. Anuj Maheshwari sir, for giving me such a wonderful opportunity as a speaker in this scientific test, that is 6th annual hybrid meeting of the ACP India 2021. Good afternoon, everyone. My topic is medical engineering fusion. Artificial intelligence in medical diagnosis and treatment. Introduction. The revolutionary invention of artificial intelligence solutions, RE, in the diagnosis and treatment of diseases with improving diagnosis, patient monitoring, disease risk stratification, identification of risk factors and treatment of patients effectively efficiently.
Dr. Brijesh, could you please move a little closer to the microphone and speak, because
efficiently and promptly at low cost. Medical engineering fusion. What is medical engineering fusion? The applications of engineering technology to the field of medicine and the goals of to improve healthcare by the infusion of medical innovations such as pacemakers, artificial hips, surgical robots, artificial organs, or to generate medical equipment or devices or diagnostic tools which having medical significance. Now, what is artificial intelligence? Artificial intelligence is artificially created intelligence by human to perform human activities. And when it incorporated with computer system to create artificial intelligence system. Artificial intelligence system has goals like reasoning, learning, planning, programming, problem solving, etc. Artificial intelligence system having a subset of artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, data analytics for making intelligent decisions when it added to data. Machine learning and deep learning is important as far as predictive properties is concerned for disease. Deep learning is a new concept with advances of artificial intelligence next generation level. Now, machine learning is a modern data analysis and unique ability to learn and improve performance with human instruction. On the other way, machine that respond to stimulations consistent with traditional response for a human, given a human capacity of contemplation, judgment, and intention. Now, deep learning, what is deep learning? It is a field of science and engineering concerned with computational understanding of what is commonly called intelligent behavior and with the creation of artifacts that exhibit such behavior. Next generation machine algorithm using multiple layer and another artificial neural network, which is equivalent to neuron in the brain, different layer approximate theory of human brain. Now, what is the role, what is the importance or applications of artificial intelligence in medical diagnosis and treatment? There are a lot of diseases of cancer which is responsible for major concern of infirmity globally. In such type of situations, AI play an important role identifying risk factor, identifying diagnosis and treatment of in such type of circumstances. So here I am taking a common or important chronic condition, chronic disease, hypertension. So role of artificial intelligence in the diagnosis and treatment of hypertension. One of the most essential application of artificial intelligence in healthcare system is the identification and diagnosis of diseases. Machine learning algorithms that are being used to identify or diagnose or predict hypertension. Identification and diagnosis of hypertension in early stage is being required to prevent cardiovascular, cerebrovascular, and renovascular outcomes. In the field of medical image analysis, many variables such as many disease lesions are difficult to diagnose, but after AI applications, it becomes easier to diagnose and find variables. Smart EHR, that is electronic health record, when it incorporated with AI-based applications, are important tasks for diagnosis and treatment of hypertension. Electronic health record with artificial intelligence used to help in making diagnosis and clinical decisions. Artificial intelligence and stress measurement. As we know that, elevated blood pressure is early and important risk factor for development of cardiovascular, cerebrovascular, and renal cells, and the use of artificial intelligence with disease outcome. Machine learning algorithms used in blood pressure measurement are photoplethysmography, ballistocardiography, electrobioimpedance, and STM superior vector machine. By using pulse wave velocity, pulse transit time, pulse wave analysis method. Now, artificial intelligence hypertension detection. Machine learning algorithms such as support vector machine and artificial neural network have been used to predict hypertension. Predicting model using machine learning and electronic health record data effectively predict doses risk for hypertension along with improving care quality and reduce healthcare costs. Now, how to predict risk for hypertension? So this is the model, predictive analysis model using machine learning and electronic health record on hypertension risk reduction. So these are the factors from 1 to 5. Age is an important factor as far as risk developing in patients of hypertension, comorbid condition, also clinical utilization cost, economic status of the patients, that is low to middle income group patients is more prone to develop as compared to high income group. Communal areas, people living common sharing area are prone to develop risk for hypertension. Proximity to fast food and bakery chains are also linked. The study details, this was taken from many hospital US. It includes 381,544 patients of low risk category. Out of which 1.19% developed hypertension in first year. And second category, that is high risk category, 41,329 patients, and 50% develop hypertension in 1 year. So as compared to low risk, so in this category is more chance to develop hypertension, and 60,065 patients have established hypertension, and 98.44% with very high risk that is chronic disease. Now, machine learning on cardiorespiratory system data for hypertension prediction. FIT project comprising 6 algorithms of machine learning. 6 algorithms like ST, LV, LVW, RTF, random forest, superior vector machine, and artificial network. So, these are the 6 algorithms of machine learning. In this fitness data, including 23,094 patients from that they were taken from 1991 to 2001 with 10-year follow-up. Data include 41 attributes. 13 were selected, while 55% male and 45% female. 50% had a history of coronary artery disease during 10-year follow-up, and 30% has hypertension. So we conclude that age is the important factor as far as prediction and risk for hypertension is concerned, followed by resting systolic diastolic blood pressure and history of hypertension and coronary artery. Now, come to challenges. What are the challenges during the management of hypertension? Pathophysiology of hypertension is heterogeneous. Model fails to capture heterogeneity of the patient, especially poorly controlled hypertension. No integration of genetics, environmental factors in clinical trial, and methodology to deal with medication is non-adherent and ineffective. All guidelines recommend salt restriction, best dietary approach to stop hypertension, smoking cessation, and reduction in alcohol consumption. But none incorporate personalized treatment and behavior modification factors, an important one. Factors which are responsible for poorly controlled blood pressure are genetic predisposition, epigenetic, salt sensitivity, sleep apnea, psychological stress, microbial community, and environmental factors are not well defined. Single trial guided by AI seems promising. Lack of update of practices, absence of proper data sets, and model fails are some of the drawbacks. And limited work on artificial intelligence at the current stage in the context of hypertension. It can be because of limitation of quality of data, computational work, presence of control and uncontrolled factors. Now come to improving hypertension treatment. How to improve hypertension in patients suffering from increased blood pressure? If it requires important points like digital transformation, data science transformation, biotech, biomedical transformation, healthcare delivery transformation, and population science transformation. So digital transformation is important one as far as treatment is concerned. Apps and internet-based tools. So home blood pressure monitoring, app-based lifestyle, and non-invasive BP monitoring, such as smart watches and bands. Data science transformation and artificial intelligence, like precision medicine, data revolution, also important. Biotech in this novel RNA, DNA, cell-based therapy. So these are all important as far as data is concerned, data collection of the patient is concerned. In our day-to-day practice, we are far from harnessing the innovative tool artificial intelligence. Although evidence of artificial intelligence being useful for diagnosis, predicting risk factors for hypertension, and its treatment. Machine learning rapidly assists multiple tasks. Social media, vital signs, ECG, echo, data capturing by wearable techniques, and deep learning has emerged in image recognition research as well as speech recognition. Capturing data from hypertension, this is likely to be improved with wearables or implantable for machine learning deep learning purposes. Personal data from patients can be added to big data, which can optimize hypertension treatment in individuals. Now, the artificial intelligence as far as future perspectives is concerned, to achieve artificial intelligence research in medicine, multiple sources of data are required. Omics, there are many types of omics, a combination of genomics, metabolomics, metagenomics, whole genome sequencing, and genome-wide association study. Input from social media, wearable technologies are required for machine learning algorithms. In future, increased use of devices. Mobile apps can provide data which can help research and development, treatment, and also reducing over the healthcare cost. Now, conclusion. Hypertension is extremely challenging public health problem globally. Challenging because of increasing population, increasing age, increasing obesity, increasing weight, and also because of diagnostic concern, because there is no alarming sign and symptom still now, in especially initial stage of hypertensive patient. And once patient diagnosed as a hypertension, it remains treated lifelong. So there is a follow-up issue. Besides this, the mechanism of or pathophysiology of hypertension is still now is not clear. Essential for genetics of systemic hypertension is not clear. So these are the challenges during the management of hypertension. Artificial intelligence has a tremendous scope in the diagnosis and treatment of hypertension. With the use of artificial intelligence, we can easily, early predict or diagnose or identify risk factor regarding hypertension, early diagnosis of the hypertension, disease risk stratification. So these are, as compared to normal traditional diagnosis criteria, so with the help of artificial intelligence, we can easily accurate, appropriate, timely, we can diagnose hypertension. And treatment of patients effectively, efficiently, promptly, with low cost or cost effective. So artificial has a tremendous scope in the diagnosis and treatment of hypertension. And artificial intelligence definitely will be an important tool in future perspective. Because we all know that still now there is no blockbuster drug for the hypertension treatment. And there are a lot of disparity as far as treatment guideline or protocol concerned from international or different societies worldwide. Besides this, there is despite this, so in such type of scenario, artificial intelligence play important role. We, on the other way, we can say at such type of circumstances, we have much needed artificial intelligence as far as treatment, diagnosis of hypertension or other chronic diseases or cancers or different types of diseases is concerned. Because there is a lot of pressure on healthcare industry or healthcare professionals or paramedics as working with the use of artificial intelligence, such type of problem easily resolved with continuous availability, that is 24/7. And there is no discomfort or fatigue problem with the use of artificial intelligence. That's all.
Thank you, Dr. Brijesh, for introducing us to artificial